Hello everyone, and welcome back to Valheim. Welcome back to another speed build. Today we are going to build a cozy little tree house, which is actually two tree houses connected to each other. And this time-lapse will cover most of the building process from the ego perspective, and I will have a little bit of a walkthrough of the final result at the very end. There will be some changes I did not record simply because they were a little bit tedious and I didn't want to, you know, spend too much time on them in the video because, you know, the POV is a little bit annoying to watch if it's too crazily sped up, so I keep it to 5x maximum, which this is. I still do want to make some recordings from third-person camera, so you have a better, nice process overview, so to say. The problem being still is that Valheim has some serious issues with the same IP connecting to a server. It is a known issue, and some people are affected by it, which unfortunately I am, and so I can't record with my second account simply because it doesn't work. After like a couple of minutes, I can't open chests anymore, I can't access the building pieces and so on and so forth, and then eventually I can't also jump into the different games. Another problem is that I'm playing that on a multiplayer server, and that means that occasionally some events pop up I can't stop, and you know, it's not that fun to build if some trolls are running around and destroying your stuff all the time. And so I better do it on my own, keep my stuff on, and whenever trolls are around I can just stop the recording and kill them right away. So that's the idea. Anyhow, so let's talk about the treehouse and what the plan about the treehouse was. So in our little area where we are living in this build, this is basically another little cozy shelter we're going to have. Basically this will be more or less my house, where I'm having my bed and my crap and stuff like that, you know. And I wanted to build this in a way that it's looking kind of a little bit unique and let's say very much man-made and not too perfect, you know. It's it should be something that is not like inch perfect. It should be something that looks like as it's more or less organically grown over time as we gathered more resources and stuff like that. And so I was really trying to make the most of the pieces available. And again, just to mention, since you will spot that I have some mods installed, I don't use the building mod. I do have it installed, I do some testing with it, but I still want to keep it more or less fair to the base building that is that has come with the original Valheim. And I think this is still the best thing to do, simply because many people out there are still doing that. I think as soon as the advanced building is becoming more and more the common stuff to use, I will jump ahead and use that as well. But for the moment being, I'm quite happy with the tools available, and honestly I still have the feeling I haven't mastered them yet, so I'm really still looking into making a bit more content with the toolbox available before jumping into something even more advanced. I guess there are still some things I have to learn and I have to get better at, especially when it comes to merging the pieces together in a nice way and make it look a bit more clean. I think my biggest issue, and I think this is also the biggest bit of criticism I have about my own stuff here, is that it's not always looking super clean. You know, I'm trying around a lot to make it look cleaner, but things most likely look a little bit too cluttered and stuff, which for the style is kind of okay, but it's in general something that do annoys me personally a little bit, and so I'm looking into improving that in the future. But you can see I'm really trying to make this over here as nice as possible. I did plant those two pine trees myself, by the way, so this is the reason why we have them so close to our hut over here. So the blacksmith is just right down there. I will show you in the real-time part later on, so you will see. But it was quite a struggle to build, especially the staircase over here. This one was really a struggle. Like, I know how to build the staircase in a way that, you know, I did a major mistake, so let me put it out this way. It would have been so easy if I just would have used the staircase trick that you can do with the pole in the middle, and then plant the tree later on. That would have been the smart thing, you know, but I started building afterwards. So the smart thing would really have been to build, like, you know, where I want to have like the tree, and then build a staircase there, and then put the tree right in the middle of it. That would have been very smart, but me no smart, so I ended up doing it a little more, you know, out of my brain, and just like how how it just appeared to be working with the tree already grown. But yeah, so this was just like a little mistake, and maybe if you do something similar in the future, maybe make sure that you do build your staircase first, or like at least the positioning of the staircase, so yeah, do you have the connector pieces, and then you can go on and plant the tree in the middle to make it better. However, this one on the other hand side went a little bit better, simply because I was building a bit of a scaffolding to make sure that this all looks good. And then, yeah, I just used the trick of using these smaller ones to make the rotation perfect. And then later on, as you can see over here, using those normal pieces to create that perfect circle, putting these two beams in to make it really look finished, and then just everything the same. And then you can also go ahead and place the walls, which I will do in a bit, and don't worry, it's gonna go and be daytime again. There you go, I just went for a little nap there to make sure it's daytime. And then from over here we started building a little bit. As you can see, this bridge over here will be gone in the final version of this video, so I will have done another bridge, because I just was not really happy with the way how that bridge looked, and I will make it a little bit different. I think this is a good idea, because I'm really not as happy with the bridge as it is. So yeah, I'm just going to do a little different variant in the end, which I think you have seen from the thumbnail, and which definitely is a little bit of a better way. I just felt like I have to, you know, change some things here and there, which I did over here. I just had a little check what I wanted to do, and so I did a bit of a different variant here. But this is also not the final design of the rooftop. I created this in... I had the idea that, you know, a kind of a rectangular one on top would be looking good when I make this building roundish on the lower part, but I just figured that the roundish bit looked better also having it on top, and so I ended up doing both roundish, and not only the lower part but also the top part of this second treehouse, which in fact is the higher one, and you can every have a like a very nice lookout over our little area where we are, settlement, you know, that is going to be a lot better hopefully in the future. So that's the idea about it. But yeah, I'm really going to improve my building here by just testing. Trial and error is really the way to go when you're not in creative mode. I know it can be tedious at times, simply because there's sometimes you just have few issues here and there with looking into different areas. And you can see I tried some things and it just didn't work out the way I wanted it to. I was quite happy with it at some point, but then again I started putting down the building over here, as you can see, and then it turned out that, you know, I wasn't really happy with the final product, and I changed it again, as you will see in a couple of seconds. So yeah, I just went ahead, put all these different tiles in, and I just made sure that this overall building is really fitting into the style of the entire treehouse idea, making it really not look too perfectionistic. And is that even a word? Perfectionist? I think this is what you would call it. I don't know. But yeah, so making sure that this looks really in line with the rest of it, so not really making it all too perfect. From the outside, it's like a perfect circle, but from the inside, I went ahead and made it a little bit more, yeah, it's versatile is the wrong word, it's just like really slapped together in a way, but that should not be a negative kind of feature. It really should be to be in line with the design idea of this treehouse, to make it look really man-made and organically grown over time. But yeah, there are still improvements that can be made over time, and you can see this is what I did over here. I just completely destroyed the overhead part here again, on the top part, to make sure to have another viewing area that is roundish, as you can see here, using these smaller tiles to create this area. But then again, to get here, I needed to come up with a different solution. I tried some things, and, you know, at the end, I succeeded with the design. The only little downside of it is it's not completely having a roof on top. For whatever reason, the game does seem to not have it as a complete roof, even though there should be a roof above everything, but it isn't, and so still stuff starts to decay after a while. I mean, not completely, because there are some crafting tables around, but yeah. So all in all, this is a little bit of a nasty thing to do, as you can see over here. I was doing some repair work here and there, just making sure that we have a way to access this upper hand area, and after a while I finally found a way of doing it, and then I had some naughty enemies down there doing some destroying things, and I needed to go down all the time, kill them, and yeah. I think at some point I will definitely go down into the creative mode to do some more stuff, because I'm just not really feeling it at this point. It really seems to be annoying all the time, and having the enemies everywhere and just being stopped from building is kind of a little bit annoying, to be honest. But yeah, whatever, this is the way it is. Anyhow, guys, I hope you enjoyed the time-lapse so far. We see each other in a couple of minutes or seconds, actually, in the real-time part, and then I'll be able to talk you through this final build of the treehouse and what is going to come next in this area. So thank you so much for listening, for watching till this point in time, and I do hope to catch you in a couple of seconds in the live part. Alright, here we are in the real-time part. As you can see, there is the wonderful treehouse in my back. And you can see there is the altered version of the bridge is already in. It's a little bit of a different one. I'm going to show you in a second how that turns out. But, you know, this is the positioning here in. I'm just going to show you real quick where it is located in the overall setup. So we do have the boat's house over here, which still is to be optimized. The treehouse is sitting over here. We have the blacksmith building just over there, and the serpent is just in behind there. Let me just punch that little neck over here. Give me, whatever. Come on. There you go. I think they're just not dropping any tiles at the moment. That's a little bit of a weird thing. Anyhow, so yeah, you can see it's looking quite beautiful from there, but we are going to have a look from up there in a second. So this is, by the way, this is where the serpent is. This is the blacksmith building, and there you have the treehouse. So it's kind of creating a nice little sideline, by the way. We will relocate also the beehives over here. They're just here for the moment. But yeah, so this is where we enter the treehouse, and I'm just gonna take away the sword. I'm just gonna run in here. It's a little bit finicky to go up. Sometimes you just have to jump a little. It's not perfect, as I said. There could be something I can improve in the future about the building. But then you go in, you have a very nice little movement over here. There's a nice little cozy area with the stone maze over here, or stone cutter workshop, so you can basically do that. And then you have a fire over here to get the rest and stuff like that. You know, we can zoom in and have a little look. But if you take that stair over here, this is where you go over into the other building, and you can just easily enter that one. We've got a nice little table to sit down on this side. You know, we can just quickly do this. Let's sit down here, you can have a lovely look into this area, or we can just have a look to the sea. That will be where the other chair comes into play. You know, this is where we have a nice little look into the sea house, or the, you know, that area where we're living at the moment. And then there's also like a little cozy chat over here. There's basically just one bed in, and you know, can put a chest in that corner if you want. This is just a little room just to get a sleep, and you know, this is basically what I did. I still have some issues with the smoke, even though there is an opened window. But if we go up here, this is where the stair comes in to play. If we go up here, you can see this is bringing you up here to the watchtower, so to say, and there is this roof open thing to make the smoke go away, but it just doesn't work perfectly fine yet, but it does work for the most part. What's kind of cool is if you sit down over here, you do in fact have a wonderful view over this entire area. You can basically overlook everything. By the way, there's my fish area to the right hand side, which I'm still not happy with. There's a couple of things that seem not to work anymore, and that did work in a previous version, but they don't work anymore, which is a bit of a pity. But that's how it is. There's our storage building and, you know, everything like that is fine. Still a lot to do, still lots of work to do, but yeah, I think it's kind of cool to have this view from over here, and you can also, you know, take out your bow and then just have a little go on the creatures around here. I mean, obviously you would enable the HUD again to do that, but I think it's... Okay, well, I smashed just that kind of fire arrow up. I don't even know why I did this anyhow. Okay, so this has been done, and then we can just go down and have a last look onto the building. There's a chest, by the way, a couple of wooden pieces in from the building. There you go over here. I still could do like a little railing over here, not gonna lie. This looks a little bit... Yeah, let me just quickly fix that. I'm gonna put like a railing in here as well. Or is this because I couldn't go... Oh, yeah, no, never mind. Then we just make a shorter one. Just to still make that look somewhat nice. There you go. Or can we actually have this one? Does this look better if we... I can't get that any higher. That's a pity. I'm kind of just gonna go do it that way. And then do we actually have... Let me just place that here. Having like a little light over there. There you go. Nice. Okay, so you can go back over here having that one. But we do go all the way down now. By the way, this is also like another area where you can have a look. This is where the dark forest is, so I'm gonna try to see that I can chop off more trees than that to see. There's like a troll cave right over there, so we can actually always shoot the troll from over here. And the range should be actually kind of okay, so that we can shoot the troll once, then he's actually coming our way, and we should be easily enough kill it from this balcony over there before it actually starts to punch the trees. So this is the idea behind that. But yeah, you can see this is the finished treehouse build. Again, it's a bit more of a funky design. It's not like super clean. This right hand side is a lot more clean than the left hand side. Also, not gonna lie, but the left hand side is looking a lot better from this angle, which is where I had the concept going. This is basically how you should look at it. This is what it was, you know, planned to be looking like, and I think this is kind of cool. This is rather good looking, and yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed today's episode of this treehouse build. If you want more stuff like that, you know, make sure to subscribe if you do enjoy the content, and if you do also enjoy the other content, make sure to have a click onto the other supposed videos at the end of the video. And now I wish you a good day. Stay safe, everyone, and I'll talk to you in the next one.